You see, they say it's just an old man talking. You laugh at an old man. There's them that laugh.
Yeah,
you
pick him up, he'll asphyxiate out there.
What does he look like?
Well, the son of a bitch is gonna smell just like the slaughterhouse.
You don't wanna go fooling around other folks' property. Some folks don't like it, but they don't mind showing you.
I've been obsessed with the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. The only way I feel it's justifiably right to pay tribute to that movie instead of remaking it, instead of making a similar movie, is to pay tribute to what happened on set while the movie was being filmed in 1973.
Interesting.
So South Texas Blues is a drama about what happened on that set in 1973 during the making of Texas Chainsaw Massacre that summer. And that is what I plan to shoot next year.
It's a narrative. It's not, in other words, a documentary.
Can I star in it?
Sure.
It's a documentary. You can't star in it. You can't star in a documentary.
It's not a documentary. I just finished saying that.
Austin, Texas is a state capital with a rich history. Late in its 20th century timeline lies the birthplace of an American cinematic legend, an independent motion picture that was created during a sweltering summer of 1973. It is titled The Texas Chainsaw Massacre. In the fall of 2005, I visited Austin for a screening of my motion picture, Horror Business, a documentary regarding the struggles of independent movie making. Horror Business played at the Alamo Drafthouse for 2 nights, and screenings were graced by the presence of actor Edwin Neal and cult film critic Joe Bob Briggs. Neal, a native Texan, who played the murderous hitchhiker in the original Texas Chainsaw Massacre, joined me the next day for a drive out to the house where a large part of Chainsaw was originally filmed. As we drove further into the Texas Hill Country, I had a feeling unlike the typical feeling one gets when watching a film like the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. It was a mysterious feeling, but not one of dread. It was a feeling of admiration. The house has since been moved from its original shooting location and converted into a restaurant. It had a haunting effect on Edwin, as if he were transported back to 1973.
Your sense of feeling changes, your sense of smell changes. It's really interesting. There's only a few places in my whole life where that happens. This is definitely one of them.
The restaurant, still and almost identically, resembles the ominous farmhouse that is forever etched into the minds of cinephiles and movie buffs. South Texas Blues is simply the story, partially based in fantasy, partially in reality, of a group of independent artists and dreamers who during one fateful summer created a motion picture and had no idea it would become a legend. It's a story that's been cultivating in my imagination for years, and the trip to Austin was an epiphany of sorts, and certainly an inspiration to find a way to film my movie as soon as possible.
What is your background in this?
I originally met Chris, what, a year ago?
Yes.
I did the poster for his previous film, Horror Business. And he liked how that turned out. And we talked about this film a little bit in the past, so South Texas Blues. And we had some ideas in common, so he asked me if I'd be interested in taking part.
Along with the screenplay, I created a series of specific shot sequences on paper. It's important to work with people that you communicate well with, and Trevor is a great example of that.
Backseat is a littered mixture
of empty fast food wrappers, papers, and various 16mm film containers. So I'm facing the driver's side like this. This scene will begin as a slow tracking shot. This is from the exterior moving in. And then a mixture of close-ups and macro close-ups cuts to a slow creeping dolly toward Toby on the camera. And he's looking that way at the store.
Right.
South Texas Blues is essentially a drama based on fact that turns its characters into fantasy legend on film. The Chainsaw Ballet opening scene is a celebration of this legend. Our story begins during the winter holiday season of 1972. Our protagonist, Toby, is a 30-year-old movie maker who has yet to make an impact with his motion pictures. Frustrated with excruciating feelings of an uphill battle, Toby reluctantly entered the department store with what little money he had. As the story goes, it was the madness inside the store that inspired Toby to conceive the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Like most visionary artists, Toby fantasized quite a bit, and it's these fantasy moments that will comprise an equal part along with the dramatic intensity of South Texas Blues. The claustrophobia was too much for him. He fixated on a chainsaw in the distant hardware department. The only relief he found was to fantasize about cutting his way out. And so it was this fantasy that inspired Toby to make his picture, and me to make South Texas Blues.